States, number one best-selling author and keynote speaker, Erik Qualman. Most of you know me as Equalman. We no longer have a choice on whether we step into digital leaders. The choice is on how well we do it. So let's get virtual, shall we?
All right, let's go to the bright board.
What's the one thing I could do that makes all the other things either go away, meaning you don't have to do them, or makes them easier?
And what all digital leaders understand, they understand the balance between the offline and the online. Jetsons and Flintstones.
So you can't replace the face-to-face, but when time and distance are an issue, we live stream.
Or in this instance, social distancing.
Now the beautiful thing is, digital leaders are made, they are not born.
Whether we're working in the office or working from home, it's imperative that we attack the morning.
Just like our bodies get tired throughout the day, our brains get tired.
So think about this lightsaber. Over time, throughout the day, it's gonna lessen its power. And that same thing happens to our brain.
It's about getting into that specific routine, because routines lead to success.
You must transform.
The best part about this exercise, it takes 2 minutes. You're gonna actually stand like a superhero.
So as we can see, digital leadership leads to innovation.
I believe it's appropriate that you're the graduating class of 2020 because it was your vision. It was your 2020 vision. It was your undeniable focus that allowed you to get to this finish line. By now, all of you have probably received a pair of these green glasses. And yes, you look marvelous.
The simple answer to your question, Kat, is that pioneers always get pushback. It's a signal you're actually pioneering.
Shanna McCormick from Hotlanta, from Atlanta, Georgia.
Now that is the question of the chat. Question for everyone at Google today. Anyone that asks a question gets a free Equalman Yeti.
Sean Miller is calling in from beautiful Los Angeles. Steven from Tampa on the Super U podcast.
All digital leaders understand one key thing, that your path is not going to be linear. With all these external changes, it's controlling what you can control. It's about being flexible in your path and firm in your destination.
When you're sailing, one of the most difficult times to navigate is when you're dealing with just wide open blue ocean. You don't have a marker, you don't have another boat to follow. And that's the world we're dealing with right now, this ever-changing world. It's like we're in blue ocean all the time. It's tough to understand where to go and what to do on a day-to-day basis.
So we can always go back to the drawing board.
In this new world of constant change, it's almost impossible to achieve our goals. Why is that? It's mainly because most of us don't understand the basics of how do we use our mind to actually help us achieve our goals. What we want to go from is a chance of 10% of us achieving our goal to 95% of achieving our goal. But how do we do that? It's all about taking ownership and controlling what you can control.
You guys look great in your green focus glasses. Thanks for rocking them here today. And also thank you for the great questions.
Writing your story during this unprecedented time. So think about shining the light on somebody else and taking that selfie mentality and doing the unselfie.
And the research shows it'll actually make you more persistent and allow you to complete that difficult task.
So in summary, the best way to juggle all your priorities at once is to actually stop juggling and to focus on the one thing that matters most.